There has been times when you were practicing and holding a pose for long just to know that the next time you did it, it was easier. Namaste, welcome to Tummee.com, a platform helping yoga teachers and teachers in training to be able to conduct classes easily. Till now, we have discussed tips on teaching different themes of yoga. We have seen how the site works and what kind of information is available. The categories we have covered are chair yoga, chakra yoga, gentle yoga, kids and teens yoga, peak poses as well. Now let us discuss a form of yoga that we all know, that is the yin yoga. A style of yoga which is pure surrender into your own body comfort. The very simple traditional yoga poses are practiced holding each pose longer, making it a challenging practice. Today we will discuss yin yoga, awakening energy points for fascia. Now, fascia is the connecting tissue between muscles covering various organs, which can be underused causing stiffness. The stiffness felt around the knee joints, lower back, shoulders are mostly because of less use of such vital muscles. Yin yoga helps in stretching these tissues, creating greater flexibility, opening passages for flow of energy in the body and allowing greater circulation, also stimulating the functioning of various organs. In this sequence, there are 12 poses for a period of 75 minutes. That is, each pose is held between 4 minutes to 8 minutes. Longer one holds the pose, greater is the stretch of the tissues and muscles, and greater is the functioning of the organs. This sequence is a pure yin yoga sequence. And we suggest such classes should have minimum number of students, so that you get to focus on each student and judge their comfortability. Before we begin, you must think, should there be a warm-up for such type of yoga sequence? So for that, not necessarily, because yin yoga is slow, deep and a cooling practice. And when a pose is held for a longer period with cold muscles, the stress created there is distributed evenly to all tissues and ligaments, resulting in a stretch. So it is not necessary to do a warm-up, but yes, this requires patience and endurance that will be developed with practice. Also, such sequences should have less number of poses and longer holds for greater effectiveness. So let us get into understanding the sequence. The first pose is the caterpillar pose. This pose is held for 3 minutes, because of which we ensure that we begin on a light note and eventually build up the muscles to do higher note poses. All throughout the practice, ask your students to keep their focus towards their breathing. Deep breathing will help in building endurance of students. Though yin yoga is not a flow, we want the transition to be smooth between poses. So releasing the pose, the student goes into dandasana and then does the deer pose. Till now, we were saying to hold the pose long on the side of the body, which is strong. But here, we hold the pose for equal time on both sides. That is 3 minutes on each side, and this is done to maintain the balance of stretch on each side. Here the student gets a good twist to the spine, helping in the flow of prana. The flexibility of the hips increases due to the placement of the hips. After which they release into dandasana and go into vajrasana to do sitting wrist stretch pose, giving a deep stretch to the arms, inner elbows. Gentle stretch to the lower back, the palm is taken in, giving a stretch to the wrist joint. Ask your students, when they are holding the pose for long, to close their eyes and take their awareness to breathing. When their eyes are closed, their sight is inwards and that helps the overall body. Releasing the pose, the student relaxes in Vajrasana and then goes into Dandasana. Transition from Vajrasana to Gomukhasana variation. Here the wrist is twisted and the stretch is felt near the hips, pelvic region and gentle stretch to the lower back. Now, how much time a student should hold a pose in yin yoga? This is something you would be asking yourself. So fascia at least requires 120 seconds of stretching to create any flexibility. So start with holding the pose for 120 seconds and then you can increase this count furthermore. We have to develop this flexibility in a progressive manner. The interlock in this pose is interchanged and held for another 4 minutes. So if you see, we have increased the holding period by 1 minute. This can go up to 20 minutes or more, but yes, over a period of time. So it's slow and more about awareness. Releasing Gomukhasana, the student comes on the fours, knees and palms and goes into Ardha Kapotasana. Here, notice how each student's body alignment is. Place a block for persons whose perineum is not connecting with the ground. Place a bolster for students who still have a long way to connect with the ground. But one thing you need to ask the students to do, once they have held the pose for 4 minutes, let them try to do the pose without a prop and see the difference. Yes, we have to be careful, but surely they will find the flexibility increasing. One more question you must think is, did we develop our muscles before we did such a pose? We did not start with Ardha Kapotasana, instead we start with caterpillar pose. So though there is no warm-up in such a sequence, but we choose poses such that they will only add up to the next pose. And that is the intelligent selection of poses. Moving on, from Ardha Kapotasana, the student does Prasaritta Balasana. You must be thinking, this is a rest pose, so why is it held for 4 minutes? This pose, besides being a relaxing pose, it helps in opening the hip joints, kneecaps, ankles and the lower back due to the forward bend. We want these tissues to stretch and open slowly yet effectively. Those extended arms help in stretching the tissue surrounding the arm. Ask the student to go to the right side of the floor. This right side stretch gives a deep stretch to the left side of the torso and vice versa. Doing this stretch on the left as well, ensure that the student holds the pose for 3 minutes or 18 breaths on each side. Besides, students noticing what's happening with the stretch, you need to continuously notice the students and if they're not pushing themselves too far. Then from Prasaritta Balasana, extend the torso front to go into Salamba Bhujangasana. The relaxed elbows, shoulders and neck makes it helpful for the spine to get all the benefit. Once the pose is held for a longer period and when it's released, the student will feel the surge of blood flow to the region like a new energy created. Ask them to notice this because this is the exact effect Yin Yoga wants the body to get. Releasing Salamba Bhujangasana, the student comes to Vajrasana and from here goes into supine position to do Supta Parivritta Garudasana. This pose works on the entire body and if you see, the interlocked legs give a twist to the hips and spine. The neck also gets a gentle twist as the student faces the opposite direction. We don't need to do anything except surrender the body to the pose and let the body do its work by accepting the stretch. After which the student comes in supine windshield wiper twist pose. This is similar to the deer pose but in supine position. So the stretch is felt around the hip region, the tissues in the upper thighs and on the side of the lower back. We all know that practice makes one perfect. Similarly, by doing a pose for longer and again working on keeping those muscles and tissues active, flexible and in use so stiffness doesn't knock the door. After doing it on the other side, release the pose and do Supta Uttita Tadasana. This is a complete stretch of the entire body from the toes up to the fingers. The spine is elongated, the rib cage is opening and the muscles connecting these regions are stretching. We want to take this another step further by holding this stretch for a good 5 minutes, that is 30 breaths. Ask the student to notice how their breathing causes movement to their chest and abdomen. Most of the times you would have noticed students sleep in such practices because they aren't moving for a long period. Like 5 minutes is long. So let them relax there in that state. But soon if you feel they might disturb other students, gently awake the person. We don't want to hinder the person's peaceful state but gently make the person aware. Lastly, let the students relax in Shavasana for a few breaths and then go into Vajrasana. And then the student goes into Balasana or Child's Pose. We are giving most amount of time to this pose, so you can choose a pose which you feel that the students will be able to hold for long. We have ended the session, but why is that? There is no specific cool down section. That is because every pose is renewing the energy in the body and Shavasana will also do the same. Besides that, students are relaxing in every pose, so the entire sequence is calm and they do not require specific allotted rest period. Besides this sequence, if your sequence has advanced poses, you would want students to have rest after such a pose. So add it, but let it be shorter than the actual pose itself. So refreshing all the main aspects we spoke about such a yoga sequence. First, in Yin Yoga, holding each pose for at least 120 seconds or 3 minutes will help in creating space between tissues. And it is about surrendering the body to time and to comfortability. Second, breath awareness. Super important, especially in case of advanced poses. Third, a specific warm-up or cool-down session is not needed because of the nature of Yin Yoga. Lastly, getting into the pose, there shouldn't be too many adjustments done or too many instructions given. Yin Yoga is to the point. And very importantly, getting into and releasing the pose should be done very carefully. So taking this sequence as a basis, create a new sequence with focus being the upper body. Like here we have focused on the hips and pelvic region. Add it to the comment section below and help your fellow teachers in sequence building. We would like to share a Facebook review by our user. We are glad that you find our system technology friendly. Subscribe to our channel to be updated on small teaching tips and sequencing tricks. Thank you very much, and we will connect soon.